All right. Hello, everyone. Welcome to day 227 of my daily drawing practice. I'm Kyle. I'm going to be continuing on this image of a woman sitting on a bench that I've been working on for the past couple streams. I think today I'm mostly going to be focused on trying to get rid of the rest of the lines. Probably. I don't know. We'll see. Other stuff might come up. We'll take it as it comes. So I haven't streamed in a couple days. But back. I've just been really tired lately. I haven't really felt like streaming. Drink is like a very bad spot. Yeah, that's better. Hold on. One sec. Okay, back. My girlfriend was just having an issue with our Cintiq. Wasn't too bad though. It was just like using the IMAX screen instead of the Cintiq screen. Which it's never done before, but sometimes stuff just gets weird. I'm probably going to be fairly quiet today unless people come into chat and start talking. I don't know why. Feeling kind of quiet. So I did a little bit of work on this off stream. And for some reason, I've noticed that since I've turned on the palm rejection, it now has this issue where I'll be trying to move the canvas and it'll just snap back to where it was before I tried to move it, which is extremely annoying. Hopefully I figure out how to avoid that. I need to look up Affinity Photo and see how close that is to coming to iPad. Seems like forever ago that they teased it, and then just nothing. I want to change this angle. It definitely is sensing my palm still. Ugh. I thought this thing was supposed to be able to reject palm input, this glove. I mean, I still like the glove even if I don't have the palm rejection working on it. It's just super annoying to not be able to pick up colors unless I lift up my hand. I might need to shop around for a different glove. I don't know why this is such a hard time using its own color picking. I've been playing a lot of No Man's Sky the past couple days. I don't know if a lot is right. I've been playing some. I don't know how I feel about it. I think the first day I really liked it, and since then it's just the more I play it, the more I'm seeing through the cracks. Yeah. A lot of the planets end up being the same. I was hoping it'd be like each discovery felt like a milestone, but it's just kind of merp. This one has green plants. This one has red plants. Remember that time we saw green plants that looked just like these red plants? Which ends up being kind of less exciting. There's also a wedding nearby, so hopefully that's not coming through. I don't think it is. this Sonic music? Not sure how much of the background I want to do. Because this image does have like a full background. I might want to avoid doing most of the background. I think I kind of like the idea of her sort of like floating in a void but still having a bench. I might try to do like a couple more things from the background but not like totally render the whole thing. Lines. And I mostly just want to get all the stuff off the bench so I can go back to concentrating on getting more detail into her. I'm mostly interested in like drawing people. I find myself like looking up a bunch of very weird things to try to use as art reference today. I was thinking about how going to the same coffee shops all the time, I keep seeing the same people and drawing the same people because of it, especially during the week. Like I go to a coffee shop in the morning and it's almost always the same folks. So I was looking for like videos of coffee shops, just like inside of coffee shops, people coming and going. Couldn't find anything, but I think that would be like really nice to not have to go out to coffee shops in person and just be able to like get the same type of experience. It's really a weird video, but I was hoping there'd be like 8 hours inside coffee shop on YouTube. There is not, from what I could find. I've been doing that most mornings. It's been pretty good. Aside from people repeating too often. Thank you. I'm tempted to do stuff after work. Like Crunchyroll is connected to a mall in downtown San Francisco. So if I go to the bottom floor, it kind of like dumps out into the food court. And I've been thinking about potentially like after work, just hanging out in the food court and drawing people. But after work, I generally just want to get home either to like play Overwatch or to just relax. So I haven't done that yet. It's still a possibility though. I think I'd definitely get much more varied options for people drawing. But I don't think I'd want to do that every day, just because I am, like, drawing does take a lot of brain cycles, and I find myself more tired on days that I do double drawing sessions. Especially like when you're drawing like real people that you're looking at, a lot of the time they'll like move almost immediately after I start drawing them, so I'll have to like invent a lot of the pose or whatever, which I think is also pretty helpful. But it takes more brain cycles to like figure out how someone's shoulder would look if they were still in that pose that you started drawing them in, you know? I was thinking about PSX today, PlayStation Experience. I went last year, and I think I want to go again this year because it was really fun. Especially if the like Neo is going to be a thing. I'm very interested in the Neo, by the way. I know a lot of people are like kind of upset about it, but I'm definitely not. I think it's really cool to be getting like a kind of mid-cycle upgrade to gaming hardware. Especially one that like people don't have to upgrade to. It's just like a nice to have situation. Still not as responsive as I want it to be. Alright, I think I'm getting to the point where I'm like okay with how the bench is for now. I might move back to working on her. I mean, who cares about a stupid bench? There's gonna be like one person that gets into chat as soon as I stop working on the bench, and they're like, oh my god, the thumbnail showed a bench! I love benches! Why have you left? Why have you forsaken me? I don't know if I mentioned it on stream, but a while ago I took off the like magnetic thing I had on my pencil. Now it's just like hockey tape basically that you'd use on like a hockey stick. It's getting like really grimy, but it feels a lot better. Still almost drop it sometimes, but overall I like it a lot better this way. And both of those ways are much better than the bare Apple Pencil. Apple Pencil is like extremely slippery by default. Yeah, it's a fucking lift up my hand. I'm like way zoomed out right now too on the source image, so I might have to zoom in. Something I did off stream the other day was I worked on her necklace a little bit. I just added these like little bobble things. These weren't in last time I streamed. I think they kind of like bring this section together a little bit more, which is nice. Welcome back, by the way, Mario Fanboy. I noticed you in chat. You don't have to say anything if you don't want to. It's totally cool. But I just thought I'd acknowledge, say that I noticed you. I was reading some rumors about the new MacBook Pros that are going to be coming out soon. Think I want to get one because my Mac Pro is like several years old at this point. But it sounds like they're going to have like a touch screen thing above the keyboard, like on top of the keyboard. It'll have like contextual buttons basically. Sounds pretty cool. What the fuck is that? Don't know what that was. Really weird noise outside. Her leg actually looks a bit flatter. Because it is like smooshing against the bench, you know? more like that. The fuck? Sounds like someone's like blowing off the horn of Gondor out there. Or like laying down like a real crazy fart. What is that? Hold on 1 second. Oops. Nope. No idea what it is. Oh well. So I have this like basically leather tote bag that I made a while ago, and today I decided to stitch a part of it that was just fastened with rivets, and it was like kind of a pain in the ass to stitch inside the bag, but I got it all done and I think it's a lot better now. That's one of the reasons I really like leather working, is you can just like have an idea and then figure out how it should be done. Like, do it, just put it together. I haven't done much leather working recently though, but I did get a bunch of Orween leather on order. I'm getting equine leather, which means that it comes from horses, and it's not shell cordovan, but it's like the part that comes next to shell cordovan. Shell cordovan is like a really high quality, like expensive leather, but for individuals they have this place called Tannery Row that you can order directly from Horween, which is a tannery in Chicago. It's like well known for its leather. Very popular as far as leather tanneries go. But they had a minimum order quantity. There was a lot more than I had anticipated purchasing. They make you order like 20 square feet, so I ended up having to buy 20 square feet of this Chromexel strips. Which I guess is gonna be cool, because like when the new iPhones come out, I'll probably start making cases for them. And I'll I have like really nice like thread too. I have tiger thread, which is like some of the nicest thread that you can get. And now I have some of the nicest leather, so I should be able to charge a decent amount for the cases that I'm going to make, because they're all like the top quality stuff. But I want to come up with like a new case design for the iPhone 7, even if it's similar. I might just add some like decorative touches or something onto it. Making cases for Androids are just too hard. Otherwise I'd do Androids too, but there's just so many different ones. It becomes really difficult because like I wet form a lot of the cases that I make, which means I need like a dummy of the phone. And for Android, I'd have to get like a dummy for each type of phone. It would just be so much work. But lots of people have iPhones, so I just end up doing iPhones. That's what I have also. And I want to be able to make cases for myself. I've really been enjoying Griffin McElroy's Nuzlocke run on YouTube. I don't know if anyone's been watching that, but it's really funny. A Nuzlocke run is like going through Pokemon with a bunch of like crazy rules. So like one of the rules that he has to follow is he can only catch the first Pokemon in an area that he encounters. So if like the first one he encounters is like a Weedle, he'll have to try to catch that, and then he can't try to catch any other Pokemon from that area. And if the Weedle dies or runs away, he just can't get anything from that area. So it's like hardcore. And if any Pokemon he has faints, he has to release it. It's like a very hardcore way of playing a Pokemon game. But similar to Dark Souls, it's fun watching people struggle against things like that. Like one of the big reasons I like watching Jeff Green do streams. If you don't know who Jeff Green is, he used to be, I think, the editor-in-chief at Computer Gaming World. And he's like a 54-year-old guy, so he's fairly old as far as like gaming streaming goes. But he has been playing a lot of like Dark Souls games, and it's really, really fun to watch him like struggle through stuff, because he'll forget where he's going and he'll like not pay attention to stuff. And for a while, like, I was watching both him and Kay Plays on YouTube play Dark Souls 1, and it's like such a stark difference, because she's very like analytical and like pieces lore together on her own and will like recognize things referencing other things, and Jeff would be like just stumbling through whatever, not realizing anything. It's really funny. You could see there that it like I was zooming in and then it like popped back out. That's what I was talking about with it like acting weird. I'm kind of sad that No Man's Sky is as boring as it is. And now I'm at a point that's like just starting to make me frustrated because there's like space pirates all over the place. And like I'm just doing my stupid planet stuff. And then pirates will come and just kill me. And I'll have to go find my stuff in space. And then go do my stupid planet stuff. It's really annoying. And like the space combat is so hard because they're like flying all around. And the aiming is bad, so like shooting them down has been really hard. Like for me at least. I've never been very good at space combat. Or aerial combat, I guess. I'm not good at like plane games either. I'm gonna zoom in on her hand. I wanna get her hands final day. So, I want to be able to get, like, veins. I want to be able to get the shading. And, like, the detail of the metal and everything. I think that's what I'm going to be, like, hunkering down on this stream. I just noticed that this is happening. There's her fingers like behind this. Because the background's really dark back here and it like kind of masks that's happening. But her fingers definitely like behind her hand like that. Trying to think about where I want to go tomorrow morning to draw. I already posted my drawing from today's session up on my blog. Anyone is interested, And then I'll also post this session's update for the bench woman. So, this needs to have more perspective. More like that. God, it's already been 48 minutes, really? Watch Mega Man music. Why are you so good? I don't think I'm gonna get the hands finished today just because there's so much do on them. Her pinky's actually like a bit straighter. More like that, maybe. Alright. I think that might be about it for tonight. I'm sorry, it's kind of a short stream. There's not much happening in chat, and I'm tired. And I'll be back again tomorrow. Another one. Maybe that one will be a little bit more lively, because I won't be working on a bench for half of it. Thank you for whoever was here, whoever watches this on YouTube. I appreciate the watch, the views, and the likes. If you do that, that's always fun. Yeah, take care, and I'll be back again real soon. You have more art practice. Be sure to go to crummyfigures.tumblr.com to check out my daily drawings. And see you later.